Good day from Chem Help ASAP. We're now going to discuss how bonds form. And to form bonds, we're going to use orbitals. Now, we've discussed orbitals before when we talked about hybrids. And how is this different from what we're discussing now? Well, hybrids are different because they start with atomic orbitals. So atomic orbitals, that includes our S, our three P's. And what did we do? We hybridized them. We mixed these orbitals, and let's say we took an S and two P's, and we would get new atomic orbitals. And these new atomic orbitals were our hybrid orbitals, so we get our three sp2 hybrids plus our P. Bonding orbitals are different because we're going to take atomic orbitals, and again, we're going to mix them, and now we're going to make new MOs, molecular orbitals. So we're going to use up our atomic orbitals to make molecular orbitals, orbitals that are shared across multiple atoms, not just atomic orbitals. So let's talk a little bit more about our atomic orbitals. Our atomic orbitals, I've shown two atomic orbitals over here, more on the right-hand side. Here's an S orbital. Here's a P orbital. And these representations are what we call psi. These are the wave functions of our orbitals. Now, what are wave functions? They're really just mathematical equations. This is a visual representation of the mathematical equation. So we would say this is the psi of our S orbital, and this is a representation of the psi of our P orbital. And psi, when I say that, I mean the Greek letter psi. So what can we do with wave functions, with mathematical functions? Well, these are what we use when we say we're mixing our orbitals. We're actually adding and subtracting these mathematical functions. And you can write stuff like the wave function of the S orbital plus the wave function of the P orbital equals a new psi of S plus P. And people actually do this, and we're going to do this. But we want to be able to represent this visually, and that's why we draw these pictures of orbitals. Now, as mathematical functions, they have values to them, mathematical signs. So when typically people shade an orbital when they want it to be have a positive mathematical sign. Now, when I say positive and negative here, I'm not talking about electrical charge. I'm talking about mathematical sign. So this mathematical function has a positive sign to it. The P orbital is different. It actually changes so that the shaded part is plus and the bottom part is actually minus. Now, it's not a negative charge, it's just a negative mathematical sign. So this is one way we talk about atomic orbitals, with the psi, the wave function, and that allows us to mix our orbitals, add them, subtract them to make new molecular orbitals. Now, there's another way that we talk about our atomic orbitals. We'll talk about the psi squared. Now, psi squared is literally what it is. We square the wave function of one of our orbitals. So what is psi squared of an S orbital? It looks almost exactly like a regular S orbital, but this is the psi squared. What is the psi squared for the P orbital? Well, when you multiply a negative value by itself, you get everything positive. So for our simple pictures, psi squared is really just the positive representation of our atomic orbitals. Psi squared gets us into what we call the probability function. The probability function. And this is really about when we ask questions, what is the shape of the molecule? We look at the probability function. Where is the electron? That's a probability function type question. So when we mix our orbitals, when we're talking about bonding, we need to use the wave function, the mathematical function. Once we square the function, we can address things. What is the shape of the new orbital we've made? Or where are the electrons in the orbital that we made? So these are ways that we invoke orbitals, atomic orbitals, molecular orbitals, to create bonds.